Welcome to another vlog. I have some more computer problems, and it's actually with rads, another rad in the house. The small one I showed you with the corrosion buildup in the one tube, I had it was calcium, and I never ran water through it, so it had to have been contaminated. This is from a different system. This is from my editing rig. There was actually two of them in a loop on one single pump with all the original fluid and everything. And as you can see, this one here isn't too bad. It's just got a buildup of white goop. Well, this is the one that's a little bit of alarming. It's like double the size, and it was once that size. I mean, it's so thin that if you squeeze it, you can feel it moving. This was ready to fail. And since the tube was gripping onto that, once that would have collapsed on itself, it would have just leaked past the seal and poured into the computer because it was on the top of the tower. So I'm starting to lose interest in water cooling. I think what I might end up doing is taking the one that's in there out and just using the stock cooler. It's not like I'm overclocking anyway. I just thought this would be pretty cool to try this. I can't remember the name of these coolers, but when I do find it in my Amazon account, I will post a link. It'll just give you an idea of, you know, if you want to go with that company or not, given that this only lasted about 2 years. And the only reason I'm actually opening is because it's developed problems, obviously. It didn't start leaking, but I did start seeing some stains around it, so like, that's pretty bad. It's like double the size of the other one. Normal. Scary. If you look at it with a loop, or a magnifying glass, you can really see the damage on the inside where it's really scored the inside. It's basically rotting out like a old plumbing. Like even old copper lines in your house will actually rot out from the inside. Just contaminants, defects in the copper itself. That's what we're seeing here. It just makes me wonder how bad the other one that is in there, how bad that one's getting as well. So I'm going to do a rebuild video. I just thought I'd bring that up. I mean, if I find a problem with like this should have lasted more than 2 years. This is my opinion. If I find a problem with a product, I will actually post it to let you know. The only thing I really modded with this cooler, which I'll show you, was the plate on the front. You can see how it's got the mesh on it. It's a pretty cool mod. It's kind of weird that the there's so much of a gap there now without the rad. But it was pretty filthy. Yeah, I'm gonna do another video, and we're probably gonna end up losing the other rad there and just putting the stock cooler on it. But it was fun when it lasted. Anyway, guys, take it easy. Hope you had a good Christmas.